no, 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 oh no, oh, twan moa ze wa ze e gift like a savior. No, 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 oh no, twan, no, 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 no. Together now, our struggle. Oh, he will come. That day is done. There's no different like the lowly Jesus. No, 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 oh, no, one. No, no. Chorus in Jebele for the last time. Uyazazi u uyazazi zizi 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 ngaye nga aye zi iyo upe elanya gako nga kumso obo unji ngo jizu gako nga Kota, ka kota.
Nyale bengelela lonke kama ingcwele lika Jesu Kristu.
To meet with you again.
Siyathokoza ukuba sihlangane ndawonye.
As we are gathering this side of eternity.
Sihlangana kule ndawo yaphakade.
In heavenly places with Christ.
Endaweni zasemazulwini no Christu.
You will forgive me. I'm not so fluent. I flew.
Uthi akekho fluent une flu.
But I'm going to revenge, no?
Uthi uzokulwisa.
And I lost my voice also in Pumula.
Ulahlekelele iphimbo lakhe sephumula.
I hope the Lord will help me.
Uyathemba ukuba nenkosi izosiza.
I will run through the announcements quickly. There will be baptism tomorrow. Those who need to be baptized.
Kuzokuba nobhaptizo kusasa lapho abathe ngobhaptizo.
You can see the deacons, they are always at the back seats there.
Lingabona amadikoni abahleli ngemva.
Those who want to see the ministers after the service, whether for prayer or special situations, you can remain behind after the meeting. And
we'd
like to thank God for the instruments that we got for our revival team and the
revival.
Guitars and the Luveve instruments also.
Lama instruments ase Luveve kanjalo.
Some for Pumula.
Lamanye ase Pumula.
Showing that there is no January disease in the missionary
work.
God heals all diseases.
Unkulunkulu yasilisa zonke izifo.
Including January disease. So, Brother Mlamule and Sister Priscilla are thanking God and all those who helped them in their wedding. And I was happy to see Priscilla singing. Normally, when they get married, they don't sing anymore. We thank God for the team that went to South Africa. Always pray for them. During the week, Brother Chokwa will be having his work there at the desk there. Those who need DVDs and books and advice, see him there. We now have morning services in Pelandaba. Our pastor for Pelandaba is Brother Zita. Those who are in the Lopengula and Makwekwe and Peri Pelandaba area. Just link up with Brother Zita and the team. You see how to do
it.
So quickly, we'll go to the scripture.
Ukuphangisa sizongena empalweni.
Stand to our feet.
Lapho siphakama ngezethu izinyawo.
I have a subject today.
Unenhloko endaba namhlanje.
That would need a lot of speed in my speaking.
Ezokudinga ukushesha kokukhuluma.
So I'll be running through the slides very, very fast.
Uzokuba egijima etshengisa emdulwini.
So watching the PowerPoints there.
Likhangele nasemdulwini.
Because I won't be able to take a series in that subject.
Uthi akayi kuthatha imfundiso enkulu ngalendaba.
So I'll take a serious
in that subject.
I
want to condense it so I will see where I can stop.
It's
a very rich subject about the human soul. I want to talk about all the mysteries surrounding the human soul.
So we'll read
the Bible now in Psalms 41 verse 4. I said, Lord, be merciful to me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against thee. I'll ask Brother Hilary to open the word of prayer.
Khulumisana lomnye lomnye wethu ngokunjalo impela Thixo ukubana washo wena uqobo lakho ukubana umuntu akayi kuphila uNkulunkulu somandla ngaphandle uNkulunkulu somandla ngamazwi akho wakhulumayo sibuthene ukubana sizokuzwa amazwi akho impela Thixo sisihlephunele leso sinkwa sokuphila kusenele impela kwethu imphefumulo ngegama engcwele kaJesu Kristu bika lokubeka ukushinyela kwelizwi kwezakho izandla uNkulunkulu somandla nomshumayele umsebenze njengesitsha sakho kubane khwaza ilizwi lakho abantu bezwe wena ukhuluma njengoba washo Nkosi yami kubana nendlebe makeze ukubana umoya uthine emabandleni silindele Nkosi yami ukuza kwakho kwesibili sifunya lathi selungiselele ngegama engcwele likaJesu Kristu yakhuleka amen and amen.
We may be seated.
Singahlala phansi.
So we'll read again in Psalms 103.
Sizokufunda kumakhubo 103.
As the song was saying, none else can heal our soul's diseases.
Akula into engasilisa isifo somphefumulo.
No, not one.
Akula lutho.
No minister can help your soul.
Akekho umshumayeli ongasiza umphefumulo
wakho. But the word of God.
Baphandle kwelizwi lenkosi.
And the power of the Holy Spirit.
Lamandla kamoya engcwele.
In Psalms 103 it says, bless the Lord, O my soul. Forget not his benefits.
To miss an inkos in Pemulo,
all thine iniquities.
Ungazo coffins, Zuzoyo, Tetanizonozako.
Oh, he let all thy diseases.
A silly celestial for Zako.
So he heals all the diseases of the soul.
We are silly as onkis for some Pemulo.
The body and the
Zomzim Balakogonke.
So I want to talk about the nature. The functions and the diseases of the soul.
It would
be a very interesting subject. I want you to listen carefully. It is said that the diseases of the soul are more dangerous and more numerous than the diseases of the body. They are spiritually transmitted diseases. The devil is the author of sicknesses and afflictions. Before we had any devil, we had no sicknesses and afflictions.
So
all sicknesses come from the devil. So if you want to address the issue of sicknesses, we address it in the spiritual realm. So the prophet says, now cancer in the body or cancer in the soul, the demon can come in either area.
Now,
many times where good people with good thoughts, good people who try many times to rest upon theology, many are here this morning, no doubt. Wherever you find Christians gathering together, we find people who have those spirits in them. They don't want them. They say, if I only quit lying, if I quit lasting, if I quit this or that,
this
devil is in the people. So even now, those demons are hiding in some people. So we are here in a spiritual hospital. Our doctor is Jesus. We are only the junior doctors under him. And we have a lot of nurses, the angels in white. And our medicine is the word of God that heals every disease. And we have the maternity department where people are born again. And we have a new start center where people start afresh in their lives. And their hearts are circumcised. And they become new. And the counselor there is Jesus Christ. And in this spiritual hospital, there is no mortuary because he has never lost any case. He specializes in things not impossible. And there are no bills because it's all for free, paid at Calvary.
those who need
to be admitted,
you
can remain here all night prayer if you want to remain here until you meet the great physician, the specialist of all specialists. And this is a referral center. What doctors cannot do, it can be done by the Spirit. The Bible says in Psalms 106 verse 15, he gave them their request, but sent leanness to their souls. So your soul can be so lean, so thin. You can be so fat in the natural, but your soul can be very thin, having spiritual malnutrition and spiritual kwashiorkor, dwarfism in the spirit, retarded growth in the spirit, disabilities in the spirit. That's why in Isaiah 55 says, buy this bread of life and let your soul delight itself in fatness. So there are some healthy souls and some very sick souls that are staggering under the viruses of the spirit, under the malnutrition in the spirit. But here we have a 7-course menu for the spiritual, for the inner man, so that you have spiritual nutrition and every vitamin that you require. The
hidden manna
of our time. So you need the immune system for your soul. In Proverbs 25:28, it says, he that has no rule over his spirit is like a city broken down without walls. So there is nothing protecting them. The spiritual HIV. Any demon that comes, it takes them.
Whether
it's fashions or music, their spiritual CD4 is very low. Whatever comes through their ears, they are down. Whatever they see in their eyes, they are down. So if you can control your spirit, that's the immunity. That's why in Job chapter 5 verse 9, by you from 6 troubles, from 7 they shall not even touch me. Those are the spiritual child killer diseases. The newborn babies of the message must be aware of these child killer diseases that will make you die without growing in the message. Initially they used to say 6 child killer diseases, but now they are 7. So that's why Job says from 6
7.
The hepatitis there. This time there is the Laodicean spirits of coldness and formality. But the best human antivirus is the word of God. When you have it, it is a repellent to the devil. It is a repellent to all spirits. It will protect you from evil thoughts and evil spirits and temptations and sins. That's the antivirus that we have. It will bring things from under cover. The name of Jesus with you. Every sick person,
there
are telltale signs. You see them lacking appetite. Yes, we see you failing to read the word. You are lacking spiritual appetite. We see you failing to say amen. That's a sign and a symptom that you are dying. Your prayer life and your reading life is a spiritual symptom that you need to be admitted at the altar. If there is no supernatural in your life, it's a sign that hey, the devil is following you. If you are not testifying, if you are not fasting, you know, when an animal is sick, you see this young boy is sick there, the vultures can sense that this thing is about to die. The demons can sense that this sister is about to backslide.
It's
about to die. The demons can sense that this sister is about to backslide. They can see how you behave in church. They can see you not playing the message in your home. And they start tracking you and following you. Then they take your eye off so that you don't turn your eyes on Jesus. And very soon it takes you away from the message. All the diseases of the soul, the worst one is unbelief.
Isso foi esse culo e
love of the world, neglecting your Bible, neglecting prayer, neglecting self-denial, being yourself, self-glory, self-righteousness, self-importance, self-satisfaction, self-interest, self-promotion, self-seeking, all those habits, and compromise and appetites and all life, and the thoughts, the imagination, the hypocrisy and the temper, sticky natures.
Look,
if you are sin positive, come to
sin
the
positive.
New start at the altar here. If you are caught in the x-ray of the word, that you are temper positive, that you are last positive,
with
an anti-last viral, all those sticky natures, the bitterness, the starchiness, and being ashamed of the gospel, and those cycles of failure, the sin of omission and commission, the stubborn spirits, the weaknesses, the unforgiving spirits, the envy, the complexes, the lust of the eye, the backsliding, the compromise, all those things. We need to have a soul examination. We have come here for a checkup. You need spiritual exercise, so that you don't lean on your own understanding, so that you are not worldly minded, so that your goals and imaginations and ambitions and
is
all centered at the word of God. So all those diseases, they are curable. There is only one incurable in the spiritual realm. Blasphemy against the spirit is the only incurable disease. All those diseases of living an underprivileged life,
wealth and music,
loss of first love, dreams, failing to respect your elders and the officer, the peer pressures and things that start creeping in your life, and the fears and the things.
Look,
if you are right now, it's a cancer in the spirit. You need medication with the word of God. You need an urgent treatment. You need something done in the spiritual realm to remove the viruses that are affecting your faith, so that all the invisible illnesses, people here are sick, but you can't tell that they are sick. Some of their BP, some of their headaches, some of their what, but you can't tell. So is it in the spiritual realm. Some people come to church with their Bibles, but they need emergency. They have non-healing wounds. They can't forgive their brothers. They can't forgive someone. If you just hit them, that wound cannot heal.
But
there's only one who can heal our soul's diseases. You know, there's a religious cancer in the church. When someone failing to operate, getting indifferent, that's a cancer in the church. It will start the whole church sick. It needs a spiritual operation. Those demons, we are attacking them with the two-edged sword of the gospel. Those cancers of cliques and clans, where those who have cast out in their own side, those who have money are in their own side, those who are in Debele are in their own side, we are cutting those cancers away. The prophets preach about spiritual amnesia, where people forget who they are and what they are here for and what the message is all about. And sometimes it's because of head trauma. When the leaders are hitting the head, this church will have amnesia. When they have seen something traumatizing in their lives, some people have seen things happen where maybe untrue ministers have robbed them, and so it takes them into the spiritual amnesia. They want the world. They say they are Christian and live in the world, live with the world, and live like the world
and
maintain their confession of being a Christian. The thing of it is spiritual amnesia. The spiritual amnesia will make a woman dress like a man. Forgotten who they are. It will make women have short hair and men have long hair. When the scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 14 says, according to that, it will make women paint themselves. Look, sister, if you want to be married, you pray. You don't act around men. You don't get into such an amnesia. The one who did that was
Jezebel.
It will make women preach when they are supposed to be quiet in the churches according to 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 12 to 14 and 1 Corinthians chapter 14. You know, spiritual short-sightedness. There are some people cannot see that there is a rapture coming. We shall not be here forever. This world is but for a season. Make sure you have the telescopic equal eyes that see ahead. Laodicea is diagnosed by spirit of being spiritually lukewarm. They are not so wealthy, but they are not churchy. They are lukewarm. They are sitting in the fence, in the world, we have to shake the fence until you fall where you belong.
Look,
if the x-ray finds you sin positive, the only answer that can remove the sin and its roots is the altar here.
What
you meet Jesus. The spiritual diagnosis says they are rich, but they say they are rich. And they have need of nothing but their wretched, miserable, poor, blind. You know, sometimes someone can have diabetes,
diabetes,
one body, and someone in the positive can be blessed, saved, sanctified, justified as being one person. Then to Laodicea, God says, this here is my prescription. Come and buy gold.
Date
your Christ. And wild raiment, the robe of righteousness, the eye self, which will solve all your problems, the revelation of Jesus Christ. When Isaiah the prophet looks at the church through prophetic eyes, says from the sole of the foot even to the head, there is no soundness in it, its wound and bruises and putrefying souls. It's long as lobo of the crutch is in the church where you don't greet your fellow. They are not closed up, sutured up, or bound, or mollified. That's what we need today. The Holy Ghost to make us totally healthy, emotionally healthy, spiritually healthy, physically healthy, everything financially healthy.
If
we look at the nature of the soul now, I want you to understand what we mean when we say the breath of life, when we say the mind, when we say the soul, when we say the spirit, when we say the gem of life, when we say the theophany, when we say the heart, when we say the inner man, or hidden man, when we say the conscience, so you see, in the spiritual process that happens in the inner man, you need to have the conviction and repentance and confession. Then you go to justification. Then you go to sanctification. Then you go to the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Then you rise to adoption. Then you are converted. You have the new birth. Then you grow spiritually unto holiness, unto perfection, unto total redemption, unto total restoration, unto the total
total remission of sin, where you are transformed and translated, then you shall be transported to God. So what happens to the man? Inner man is what happened to the earth.
Water baptism in the days of Noah.
After 2,000 years, blood of Christ. Now the fire of the Holy Ghost. So the inner man needs water baptism and the sanctification blood of Christ and the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So it types the spiritual. So in us, we need to be redeemed totally. Look, when you are saved, God does not remove all your weaknesses in one day. Like he told Israel little by little. You have to fight your weaknesses. You have to guard against your weaknesses. As I have said many times, that the greatest weakness is when you cannot know your weakness. If we come to church for any other objective than this, I'm afraid we don't get too much from coming to church. We must come to find out our weaknesses, our bad places, how little we are, and put our trust in someone who is strong so that you get perfect strength. So you have to be strengthened in your areas of weakness. Like the man of Hebrews 11,
he
says, out of weakness they were made strong. So where you know if your weakness is music, pray for strength in that area. If your weakness is temper, pray for strength in that. You must know the sin that easily besets you. Then you can have perfect strength when you trust him. Notice the weakest and the rejected. Practically every hero God has ever put in the front line is a person that is rejected, a person that thought is insufficient, a person that has no ability at all. God takes the weakest instruments. You have to lay aside that sin that easily beset you, that is your weakness. Everyone has something that easily disturbs them. To someone is pride, to someone is internet and TV.
So you
have, as long as you are in this life, you are going to have sticky and carnal nature that is going to bother you as long as you live. But the inside of you is born again. So let's look at the scriptures on the soul, so that we know what is the soul, what is the spirit, what is the three parts of man.
In Hebrews,
says we are not of them that draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe unto the saving of the soul. It says in James 5 verse
20,
he that converted a sinner from error shall save his soul from death. So these are the scriptures about the soul. Ezekiel chapter 18 verse 20, the soul that sinned shall die. The son shall not bear the iniquity of the father, neither the father bear the iniquity of the son. Even if your father is a preacher, he cannot carry your salvation. You must have your own experience with God. Even if your father is a deacon, you must have your own experience. Christ says, fear not those that kill the body, but they are not able to kill the soul, but rather he that is able to destroy both the body and the soul in
him.
So some of the diseases can kill the body only, but the soul they cannot kill. Jesus said unto them in Matthew
22,
thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. So you have to, that is the first commandment, the greatest commandment, to love him with all your heart, and all your understanding, with all your soul and all your strength. What can a man give in exchange for his soul? There is a rich man in the Bible.
Who said, I'll make bigger pans.
Luke 12 verse 19.
I'll say to my soul, thou is good. What are you telling your soul today? I want my soul to be full of the Holy Ghost. I would rather have Jesus than all the silver and gold. But God said unto him, thou fool, this night thy soul is required of thee. So you have to build your hopes on things eternal. And there is a constant battle between the spirit and the flesh. As it is said in the spoken, that there are two dogs that are fighting in me. Which one is going to win? The black or the white? The one that you feed most. If you are feeding your flesh on the things of the world, it's going to overcome the spirit. In Romans chapter 8, it says, the works of the flesh are manifest. Even in Galatians, it's written, Galatians chapter
5,
that the works of the flesh are manifest. Adultery, fornication, uncleanness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, emulations, right? You know, hearing the message, we don't prophet to the Jews that shall come, Moses and Elijah. So in the visions and discernments, the prophet will say, I'm contacting the spirit. When you would contact your spirit, that spirit had a megabyte to contain all your data. From when you were a young girl, from when you were a young boy or young girl, you would say, I see you becoming small. I see these walls dissolving. He's entering another dimension. And in that 1 second, you could retrieve spiritual data about your parent and your address, about where you come from, about whether you are a Christian or not. What a USB cannot carry, it has so much gigabytes in your soul that the heart of Christ could receive the spirit without measure, and the heart of Legion could have demons that hundreds of pigs could not
care.
That's the spiritual capacity of the soul. And the prophet says, sometimes some sins can get to the gap end of your soul. And there is nothing that can remove it. It's now at the apex of your heart. I said that's at the gap end of your soul. They could pour a gallon of oil over you and kick and stomp and cut these devils as they want to. But the cure of it, if you have a sin at the gap end of your soul, you have to confess it to your husband. If you sinned against your husband, to someone that you sinned against, then that confession opens a drainage for that devil. It opens a suction for that devil. We now can suck it out of your soul. So the inner man, the gene of God, is not from this world.
Yes,
theophanic behavior. And then this outer man, made of 16 elements, calcium, copper. Now listen, in those 16 elements, there is no gold there. That's why you keep running after gold. You start running after silver and what? Because it's not in the 16
elements.
Now the prophet says, you are like a grain of corn. That's why Jesus says, unless a grain of corn falls into ground, no matter what color the grain of corn is, whether you are black or colored or white, it has three elements. He says, now a seed has a shell on the outside, that's your flesh,
as
the power of where the germ of life is. So there's the chaff, the outside of the maize, which is taken by the winds, like the flesh taken by things. As I'm preaching, some of the people are not concentrating because they are tossed to and fro. So then there is the white part of the maize which stores the food, which is the spirit which stores the food of the soul. Then there is the inner yellow part of the maize, which is called the heart of the maize. That's where the future life of the maize is. When these demons there, when these creatures there, with these anti-germination demons, when they eat the inner part of the maize, it cannot germinate. So don't fear those who destroy the body
only,
but ye that can destroy both. So to your inner part and your outer part, they speak different languages. In times of sicknesses, your soul says, by his stripes I'm healed. Your sickness says, I'm sick. Your outer side says, I'm sick. When a man is converted, it doesn't mean that here is a good, deep teaching. I hope you get it. We are surely getting to that real good deep teaching. The deeper things of God. Now,
we
want to see the soul and the spirit, what is, which is what? So, before 63, he used to say imagination, the five senses of the soul were imagination, conscience, and he said the soul is the nature of the spirit. Because the soul only puts an atmosphere of on the inside of you. So now let's look at that a little bit. What is the difference between the soul and the spirit? Since the word of God can divide asunder the two, what the soul is and what the spirit is. But I know my soul says yes to the word of God. Look, when the spirit of Elijah comes five times in the Bible, never did the soul of Elijah come five times. The Holy Spirit, the spirit that anointed Elijah to do those works, it came again on this person and that person and that. Maybe someone who is badly dressed. When the prophet says, turn your eyes, turn your head, that thing goes through the gate of your eyes. Then you start reasoning and saying, oh, is it how bad it is in the world? All the legs outside. Is it how the fashions? You are now imagining. By the time you put a handbrake, you are gone. You must have an alarm system. Something that tells you, turn your head. Something that tells you, this is the devil.
Long
Satan. You know, the outside man is bombarded by temptations and we are surrounded by those things. The man who is on the inside can silence all the outside influence. As if it does, it doesn't exist. If you are shut in, if God is in you, greater is he that is in you than all the pressure outside. All the pressure for stealing and the lies, fighting, hate and pride, selfishness. But inside, we have something in us. Now we have a spiritual digestive system where when you hear the word, it must go somewhere where it works. It must move from your mental faculties. Christ cannot function in the intellectuals. It goes beyond the intellectuals. It got to come to the heart. And the heart is now, it's a different mental faculty.
It's now
Jesus on the inside working on the outside. When your faith comes out of the intellectual realm, the Holy Spirit puts it in your soul and heart. It won't even, you won't even think about these things. You won't try to see nothing. The only thing you know is going to happen regardless of who says it or not. It's in your heart. Something is telling you, Although there is a constant battle between your intellectuals and your heart. As I'm preaching, I'm telling a sinner that you can be saved today. And your brains are telling you, I've been a prostitute. Oh, I've aborted. Oh, I've killed someone. Look, the blood of Jesus can change even let him
appear.
Or even the vilest offense. If you listen to the tag in your heart, your heart is going to overcome in all the battles. Lean not on your own understanding, but listen to this also. To balance things, you don't follow your heart only. Follow the conviction of the Holy Spirit. I've heard some people saying, my heart does not condemn me. It's dead. You have killed the conscience. How can it condemn you? Now, I want you to listen to this numerology of the Bible. Number 3 in the Bible. How it runs in a Christian life. It's a number of perfection.
Important
is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. These three are one.
It's
three gods, right? The Old Testament tabernacle was the outer court, holy place, and holiest of holies. Those are the three things. There are three realms where there are human, where there is existence of man. It's heaven, earth, and the under the earth. And three things about salvation: it's water, blood, and spirit. And the body, soul, and spirit. So those are the three things about you. There's been three major dispensations: antediluvian, first pool, touch, contact with the flesh; second pool, contact with the spirit; third pool, contact, speaking the word directly. In the Jewish time and our Gentile time now. Even if you have three bedrooms, you have kitchen, bedroom, and lounge.
And
in the salvation of the soul is justification, sanctification, and baptism of the Holy Ghost. The state of matter is solid, liquid, and gas. There's the water that you can touch, like your body that you can touch. And the water that flows like the spirit. And the water that you cannot see like your soul, right? You cannot touch. Even there are three colors that make other colors. Even in electricity, there are just three cables that run these things. But life is not in the outside, the earth, this body, right? It's in the life wire where the soul is. That's where the soul is alive. That's where the spiritual electricity, the powerhouse, the power of God. Even the ministry of the prophet, the three pools to the soul, and the vision about the third pool, the three elements.
He
saw the big tent, the tent, and then the platform, and then the small inner house there. Those were the three major realms of the third pool vision. And there's the first heaven, second heaven, and third heaven. Those are the threes that run through a Christian. The effect of true revelation of the God, that these three are one. It's the same God right down through the dispensation of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Listen to the effects of that revelation. Father, I tell you that would punch the devil in the rib every day. And will make him squeal like a pig. That's right. Because it's the power of God being revealed in the last days. I have something today that will punch the devil in the rib every day. So these three things about the realms of salvation. In Revelation chapter 14, there are three messengers that come in the last days. Three men that came before the destruction of Sodom. Elohim remained with the bride. A transfiguration, there were three people. Jesus, Moses, and Elijah. Three men that met Saul. The third one was carrying wine, the stimulation of the
Lord.
The threefold purpose of the gospel. The three exoduses. First from Canaan, physical. From Egypt to Canaan. Second from law to grace. The last one from denomination to the
pride.
And when John hears about the characterization of the universe,
he
says there was no man in heaven, one,
and
two, and under the earth. So I want you to notice that number three running through in the Bible.
Paul says,
now abided faith, hope, and charity. These three, but the greatest one is charity. Even the sixth seal, three things about it. The threefold events in the sixth seal, the purging of the foolish virgins, the calling of the
144,000,
and the disturbance of nature, purification of this world. The threefold purpose of Christ. First, he wanted to reveal himself, expressing his attributes. Secondly, he wanted to have a body of believers that you can have preeminence, a church where you would dwell in them.
Thirdly,
he wanted to restore. This is the days of restoration. So those three run in the Bible. The dove was sent from the ark three times. And the people who replenished the earth were the three sons of Noah,
Japheth,
Ham, and Shem. It's New Testament. It was the Jews, Samaritans, and Gentiles. So number three will run through the Bible. Even the third pool, the seventh seal, three things about. It was a threefold mystery, the seventh seal. And the rapture has three things about it: the voice, the shout, and the trumpet. I hope you are getting the spiritual deep things. There are three raptures in the Old Testament. Enoch, Elijah, and the Old Testament
saints.
And in the New Testament also three raptures. The Christ, New Testament saints, and our Moses and Elijah.
And
there are three comings of Christ. I want you to notice that number three running through. He came at Calvary to pay the price. And the rapture now take us away. Then he comes with us for the millennium. And there was the outer court, holy place and holiness of holies. A Christian who is filled by the Holy Ghost lives in the holiness of holies. He's chatting with God, he doesn't, and the veils are soundproof. He doesn't know what is outside there. He's living in the inner. Eating of the hidden man. That's why the shape of the temple in the Old Testament was shaped like a human being, showing you are indeed the temple of the Holy Ghost. This is the structure. The head was the holiest of holies. The intelligence, where we have the mind of Christ. The head, like the priest's head, was the treasures, the rooms of the priests. The two ends were the other rooms of the priests. The five fingers, this side and that side, were the levers where they washed the sacrifice. The two legs were the two structures, the board and the jackson. The feet were the altar of sacrifice. So you come to the feet of Christ at the altar of sacrifice. So that symbolism, that number three in the Bible, Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. That number three in the Bible song. All those tabernacles, but I want you to notice the devil's trees also. The Bible says there are three. Unclean spirits like frogs. So the devil has his own threes also. He says, money, women, popularity. That's the devil's threes. Nicolaitanism, Balaamism, and Jezebel religion. And the three-ism, Nazism, fascism, and communism. The triple crown of the devil. And his false teaching on purgatory. That is the vehicle of purgatory, earth, and heaven. There is nothing like purgatory. We are perched here at the altar. Listen, this the devil's threes. In Genesis 3. The woman saw one that the tree was good for food, one, and it was pleasant to the eyes, two, and desirable to make one wise, three. These are the three things in the world: the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. He gave three temptations to Christ, and Christ says, the thief cometh not, but to steal, one, to kill, and to destroy. Those are the threes of the devil. So Revelation 16 says, there are three unclean spirits out of the mouth of the dragon, one, and out of the mouth of the beast, two, and out of the mouth of the false prophets, three. Those are the spirits of devils working miracles. Don't just believe every miracle. Chains and chambers are there in the outside in the last days. Just hear what they are saying. Don't just believe everything. The devil's threes. It says in Revelation chapter 9, by these threes, the fire, smoke, and brimstone. He killed people in those days. The devil's threes, as we are about to rush. The prophet says, now remember, the Antichrist and the beast is the self-same spirit. There is a trinity, yes. Three stages of the same power. See? Now watch this. The three stages. He is called the Antichrist. Second stage is called false prophet, and then it's called the beast. I want to expose the three things about the devil. Now, when the first place in the realms of hell and demons, this side is souls of the unjust, the regions of the damned. Then comes the regions of demons. Then the third hell, like the third heaven, where Satan is. So the devil has his own threes also. And the hell and the grave. The trinity of the devil. Those are the three things about the devil. He has these three powers that makes him a devil. In the positive, there's water, blood, and spirit, which is of God. But in the negative, there's politics, religion, and demon power. God works in a trinity, right? Justification, sanctification, and then he incarnates himself in the believer. The devil, it does the same also, incarnates himself. The white horse rider. By the time the devil incarnates himself in the man, the superman that people are waiting for, God will be now incarnate in us, the believers, working the third pool, the mystery of the seventh seal. So now so must reach the stature of a perfect man. You must have faith, virtue, knowledge, temperance, patience, godliness, that to guide you from all and shelter you from all sin. And then the capstone of love comes down. As we are living in seven dimensions, these are spiritual numbers that are running through. A man and a woman. Listen to this. If you are afraid what your mother is going to say, or what your pastor is going to say, or what so and so is going to say, you are still scared and walking after these things that you see with your eyes. But when you fed that peg, What the pool room gang will say.
What
the movie gang will say. What the women you associate with will say. What your schoolmate will say that you are old fashioned
rock.
If you quit rock and roll. If you look at that, you are in the flesh. But when God comes in the control tower, then you look at him, you are not afraid of any other thing. In the you can refuse anything that in your soul brings. If you bring sickness, you say you refuse to sign. If you bring, I want this, to you to look at this illustration here. There comes the devil with a delivery. Sometimes the devil is delivering things to your address there. He says, I have a package for Mr. John Cena, Joe Cena. Then this born again man says Joe Cena died and didn't leave a forwarding address. My name is Joe sanctified. I refuse your delivery. And there is the grave where he was buried at the altar. Person possessed with demon power. They've got four times strength. If the devil can give you four times strength when you are possessed with him, what about when you are possessed with the Holy Ghost? How much power can you have? You know, at the cross, every wrong thing was nailed there. When the devil tells you you are a sinner, all the hypocrisy is nailed at the cross. All your vile machinations are at the cross. He has blotted everything about you. Now, let's look at the senses of the soul. Your soul has two senses. To choose your way or God's way.
Ketako
Sarudza yako nzira imbiri. Enye iya ekufeli.
Imwe nzira inoenda
murufu. Enye iya ekuphile.
Imwe inoenda mukurarama.
And souls are choosing right now.
Imphefumulo yakhetha ke manje.
You know your soul has the right to choose.
Umphefumulo wakho unomasikethela. Ukubana iphakade lakho
lemi kanjani. Let me announce today that with God.
Mina ngimemezela namhlanje kubana noNkulunkulu.
Nothing shall be impossible.
Akonto ebukhuni.
The greatest of all miracles.
Isimanga esikhulu kuzo zonke.
Your soul is saved.
You
know, even your natural birth
is
a big miracle on its own. Everyone on earth started as someone smaller than a grain of salt. You started as a sin, then you started multiplying and multiplying.
You started as
so you must believe the unseen things.
The
things that appear
are
not made of things that appear. So in the unseen world, receive everything that you desire. Because you were manifested, there was a time where even a scan could not catch you in the womb. So there's a time where even scan cannot catch your healing.
When
the x-ray cannot catch your healing, and they say, we still see the TP. There was a time when they could not see even your mother's womb. But listen to this, the greatest miracle is when you are born again of the incorruptible seed. The greatest miracle ever performed
is
when God can take something and convert it, bring it back to itself again. Just as you can take an animal by science
and drop
a little water on a hog
and
make him a lamb. Now that's the miracle of it. Change the whole nature and appetites and everything. That's the reason I used to go to the normal. That's what God does when he saves a man from sin. He changes his entire makeup. So greater than any miracle or divine healing or raising someone from the dead or
what,
is when a sinner is saved. I always say, sometimes we put the cart before the horses. We
pray
for a blind man, he receives sight, he starts lasting after him. Because he's not saved on the inside. We pray for for a man on the wheelchair, he goes to the piano. Because he's not saved on the inside. We pray for you to get money. Then you go and book hotels and do sin there. Because you are not saved, you still have the greatest miracle. The greatest miracle ever performed. Forgive a human of its sins. Take a man and convert him from things. And change his innermost thing, being. From the things when he once drank and dabbled suddenly turn him around and he has love now. He goes back home to his life. All the small house things are over now. He says, honey, I'm sorry. I have treated you like that. He picks up his little children in his arms and daddy spent all money in whiskey. Daddy has done this. And the mother has been all night and left you with children. I will never do it, God forgive me. Tablet can make a temper stick in someone. Be kind. But there's the gospel here. Now, John the Baptist. Receive the Holy Ghost in the mother's womb. Let me show you a mystery. That embryo has a soul. If you are bought, you have killed someone. You better repent, because one day you shall meet those. What do you use women for removing? Is this one? Alright, you will tell me afterwards, right? Make sure you repent, otherwise you find 10 children waiting for you. I like it when Paul repented. Though he had killed Stephen, but now they are rejoicing together in heaven. You will rejoice with those children if you repent. Jeremiah was sanctified in the mother's womb. He says, I formed thee in the belly, in your mother's belly. Before I formed thee, I sanctified thee and made a prophet. To Isaiah, he says, I called you when you were in the mother's womb, predestinated for this. We have come for such a time as this. Some people, God says, Isaiah 48, you have been a transgressor from your mother's womb. That's why you need new birth. No person chooses his parents or race or social. You are predestined. All those God knew where you shall stay. And in Psalms 139, he says he knows your down sitting and your uprising. He understands your thoughts before you were even born. He says he possessed your reins. And you put you in the mother's womb there. He says, I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, that my soul knoweth well. My substance was not hid from thee when I was curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Thy eyes did see my substance, yet being unperfect. In thy book all my members were written, when there was none of them. Before you were there, God saw that you shall be tall or light. There's no microphone that can change that. So now there are three wombs that the prophet talks about. Your body was in the womb of the earth. All your 16 elements were in the womb of the earth. Then you are now in the womb of the mother. But now there is a spiritual womb that your mind is the womb of the spirit. Everything that you can get is conceived in your mind, in your right mental attitude. The finances and the healing that you get, you must go through the bad pains of it in the spiritual womb. Now, even when Christ to realize the great plan of redemption, there are seven major theophanies. appearances.
Waziveza ngomzimba kamoya
ngasikhombisa. We were somewhere before we were in the flesh.
Ukusithengisa ukubana sasikwenye indawo singakaveli ngokwenyama.
Christ came through.
UKristu engakaveli waza.
A virgin birth.
Ebuya ngokuzalwa ngokwentombi.
There were seven major theophanic appearances.
Wabonakala ngasikhombisa ngomzimba kamoya.
In a body not of flesh.
Esiza ngomzimba
kwenyama. Where were you when we shouted for joy?
Wawukuphisa ihlokoma ngentokozo.
In the heavenly realms, in the mind of Christ. He came first when he was walking in the Garden of Eden.
He
came again as
Melchizedek.
He came to Abraham as Elohim. He came to Moses. And he saw the back of a man. He came as the God burning the fire. He came as the captain of the host. He came as that angel that rescued Jacob.
So
we have spiritual genes.
We don't walk
after the outward things. We have the spiritual DNA of God. We shall be what God said we shall be. Nothing shall oppose it.
The
Bible says whosoever is born of God does not commit sin, because the seed of God, the gene of God, remains in him. It makes you overcome. Though you came in this flesh and bypassed your theophany, there is something in you that is the spiritual gene of God that exists equally as your natural outside body exists, that tends to eat it as much as your flesh eats, that tends to bath even as your flesh has to bath. No one can tell me that no, I bathed yesterday. You have to bath again today. Don't tell me, I received the Holy Ghost yesterday. You need another touch. In as much as you go and anoint your body in the natural, your inner man must be anointed with the Holy Ghost. In as much as you dress your outside body, you must be dressed with righteousness. In as much as your natural body is a home, my heavenly home,
it's
bright and fair. I feel like traveling. And
home.
Where your treasure is,
there
your heart is. In as much as your natural body has parents, your soul has parents. Some people don't know the parents of their soul. It's the word and the spirit. We have a destiny. We have the spiritual genes, the bride, the one that is going in the rapture. Nothing is the bride only. The elected ones forlorn, they have the father's spiritual genes, the gene of your life, spiritual life today was in God before there was a molecule. You are nothing but a manifestation of
that
everything about you and what you shall pass through. We have the gene of God in us.
That
we are. We have become from mortal beings, from time beings to eternal beings. When the word of God lit our souls, we become sons and daughters of God, with the attributes of God in us, crying Abba Father. We have the heavenly genetics that cannot be hybridized. Now, by natural genes, someone can inherit temper.
A
natural DNA, like what the prophet says here, maybe a man is born passionate. There are some people who are born high passion. There is no girl that can pass before them without them breaking their neck. There is no boy that can pass before them.
I'm
telling you, even if they are singing specials here, someone is busier.
Oh, special.
There, he is constantly in trouble because he's born like that. Listen, my brother. One answer for you is a transfer of spiritual genes. You know, when there's life in you, it can never be hidden. I've seen grass germinating in the cracks of a concrete.
No.
When something is you, is going to express. When God is in you, something is going to show that that you have the Holy Ghost. All nature waited for the manifestation. Not of demons, but of the children of God. Together somewhere. How did they know that this is Moses and Elijah? How did they know in Matthew chapter 27? This is Abraham, this is Sarah. How did Nebuchadnezzar know? That one is the son of God before Christ was born. How did he know God is a son? How did Abraham know that this is Elohim? I shall know him, You know, in that rapture, no one shall introduce me to Daniel.
Daniel.
We are all from the Hebrews 11
family.
You are not complete without us. We all have the same gene in our heart. Our heart is beating with the blood of Jesus, with the life of Jesus, Jesus working inside. You know, a fruit has to ripen from the inside. Then it changes color on the outside. You have to be born again on the inside, on the core of your heart. The spiritual core of our being.
Now,
let's look at the human heart.
Ezekiel
says,
Ezekiel,
a new heart also I'll give thee. And the new spirit I'll put within you. Listen to all those highlights there. A new heart. A new spirit. And I'll take away a stony heart. I've seen us operating and removing gallstones. But now we need to remove the stony heart out of your flesh, and I'll give you a heart of flesh. You
know,
there's a soft heart that can say amen. There's a soft heart that can respond. It does not sleep in chains such a heart. It does not lose concentration such
a...
I'll put my spirit within you. Listen,
la
the new spirit has confused many people.
Loko
and they think they have the Holy Spirit. Wait at the altar there until the true Holy Spirit comes. And you will behave like Paul and Silas. You
will
behave like all those who receive the Holy Ghost. Then the message won't be burdensome. That's why... David says in Psalms 51, create in me a pure heart, O Lord. And renew a right spirit within me. Now there's a danger in churches of people receiving human spirits and religious spirits, thinking it's the Holy Spirit. The prophet says, you go to a meeting and the pastor checks his head like that. You find the whole congregation is checking their head like that. You go to a meeting and the pastor is wide on fire. He's running through his head and he's doing somersaults. You watch everyone in the congregation acting the same way. But you go to a place where the pastor is a solid gospel teacher. We'll never move that church. Emotions have their place. But we need real rooting and grounding in the gospel. Brother, you take one another's spirits exactly right. You take one another's spirits instead of the Holy Spirit. Just like a good man can take a bad woman's spirit over his face. I've seen in marriages a good spiritual brother marries a lazy low faith
why?
Not very long. You may find either the woman full of faith
or
the man full of doubt because they are taking one another's spirit. But now the key to your heart,
there's
a mystery about the heart. Outside door. Many people open the door to Christ. But there are other small doors inside their houses that they don't want to open. When they were baptized, they opened and said, yeah, I want to be a Christian. But there's a door where they are hiding dirty magazines. They don't want to open that door. There is a door of bedroom filth. They don't want to open that door. There's a door of dishonest. What they do when they are not in church. But when I was born again, I said, every door, may the Lord rule there. Now, this article came in the net there about someone who had a heart transplant. And their behavior changed because of heart transplant. It is written there in yellow there. I was given a young man's heart. I started craving for beer and Kentucky Fried Christian chicken. My daughter said, I even walk like a man because of a man's heart, right? There is a woman who became a lesbian because of lesbian heart. This person there, Claire Sylvia, in mail there, told of an extraordinary story of a heart transplant where someone who received a heart transplant for someone who committed suicide. And they also committed suicide. They also married the former wife of the one who gave that heart. They started loving the wife of the person who gave the heart. That's why the Bible says in Proverbs 4 verse
23,
keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. If you like miniskirts, your heart is a projector of what is on the inside. If you like going to the beer halls, your heart is like that. One woman who believes this to be the case says she was 47 dying with a chronic heart disease.
Why am I 47?
And pulmonary hypertension in 1988. She had a heart and lung transplant. She was given the organs of an 18-year-old boy who was killed in a motorbike accident. She was a professional dancer, but she seemed to be craving for things that the donor of the heart was craving for. She started drinking beer like the owner of the heart. When I read these things, I remembered when I was a young boy. In form 4, I had a heart disease. Then I underwent a heart transplant. Then Christ removed a stony heart. And now it's no longer me that is the one that gave me the heart. I gave him my old tattered garment. He gave me a robe of pure white. Now it's no longer I that gave
him.
It's Jesus.
Yes.
Now let's look at our spiritual anatomy. Now let me dissect your being now. On the outside you have the body. That is the first outside veil of flesh. The bare skins outside. And then there's the spirit where your emotions and
temperament
and moods and things. But as we go inside into the heart there, into the controlling tower there, that's where where the gene of God is. I want something that happens from the inside. If an egg is broken by an outside force, life ends. But if it is broken by an inside force, life begins. Great things begin from the inside. Do everything from the inside. You can't help a chick to hatch.
You
say, let me crack it a bit for you. You will kill it. Leave them at the altar to pray. Leave them to confess. Leave them to have their breakthrough.
Now,
that chick there.
It has given something.
In his mouth there. That is to beat that egg. No mother can help. The mother just gives an atmosphere. As that chick beats that
chick,
I don't want this situation. I refuse this spirit. One day, not known by the mother, not known by the farmer, not known by the chick itself, that shell will break. One day you have a breakthrough. So your heart is that throne of God. Like your natural heart is surrounded by 24 ribs, 12 this side and 12 that side. And there's 4 chambers. Now the throne of God is 4 living creatures. One like an ox, one like an eagle, one like a lion, one like a man. As in this picture, 24 elders, 24 ribs around your heart, 12 this side, patriarchs, 12 apostles, removing Judas and putting Paul there. Now, the first throne of God was in heaven. Now his throne is in your heart. There is a special sofa in your heart, which even your wife cannot sit in. Which even your husband cannot sit in. Only Jesus. He cannot shade with anything your aunt and your mama. They have lesser thrones around your heart, where the next one is your wife and up to the last one there. So it's exactly a pattern of things in heaven. Now the scientists have tried to oppose this thing about the heart. They've tried to invent an artificial heart. When Christians become artificial, everything about them is artificial. Everything, hopes and hands,
artificial.
You see people now having an artificial heart. But this heart cannot operate without being connected to a machine. So you can't move from that machine.
So
there are some people who cannot be Christians without a preacher next to them. We need to hire a preacher for them. That if you they touch this, we say, hey. If they look at that, we say, hey, this is an African movie. This is a pornographic site. As long as they have no minister, they are not I was such a person. Then I got a teacher inside. He taught me how to watch and pray and live rich, sing every day. I have two birthdays. When Jesus was my sins. If you have such a day, if you are born twice, you will be such an odd bone. You be such a mystic to others. There will be an instinct in you. Something that when you speak wrong things, it says, go and apologize. There are some people who cannot say sorry. And because they cannot say sorry, they have sorrows. There is something in a man, a homing device.
GPS in a man that tells him it's time to go to church. I was happy when they say that to me. There is an aerial in a man that tells me that no, something good is about to happen. Animals can tell when an earthquake is about to happen through an instinct, but we have a deeper instinct, hungry and thirsty for the deeper things of God. Now Timothy says, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in later times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seduce with spirit and doctrines of devils, speaking in lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience see it. Some people, their conscience is dead. They can do anything and there is nothing that tells them. When you are hungry, your body has an alarm that tells you. If you don't listen to it initially, it's going to embarrass you. It's going to make a sound that says, I told you I'm hungry. So if you don't obey your conscience, one day you do a wrong thing when other Christians are there. You know, you have your conscience and your subconscious. But the prophet says, if you are a prophet, your conscience and your subconscious is so close together. Without you sleeping, you can step into the unseen world. And every Christian under the anointing can step into the world of the unseen. Now they invented a light detector that they put around you. And if you are lying, do you know a lie changes your heart rate? And your blood pressure and your respiration rate, because your body was not meant to lie. If you register in a machine that someone is lying there, but there's a natural light detector. You know, the first light detector was the Urim Thummim. It was to tell them that this is not true. The first light in gates was when Peter gates opened on their own. The first scan was when Rebecca went to God and she was told that they are twins. The spiritual world is always ahead. Listen to this verse. I'll see where to close. The spirit of a man will sustain his infirmity, but the wounded spirit who can bear.
God, do you know
the spirit of a man? I've seen sick people
who are
almost dying, outliving strong people, because they are refusing to die. There are some people who say, me, I will never die without driving a good car. Even if they were born poor or what, the spirit that is the one that will bring something. If you say, I will never die without having a good house, now that thing in you will make sure against all odds you will have a house.
Now,
the Bible says in Proverbs 17, verse
22,
and Mary had doeth good like medicine, but a broken spirit dried the bones.
I
want to show you a mystery. If you are always angry, though that demon of temper, I want to expose some demons that work together. There are some spirits that are friends. If one comes in, it invites a friend. Watch someone with a spirit of temper. They will have grudges they can't forgive, because those demons operate together. Very soon they will have a PP, because the demons of PPs operate. They are given power from the temper spirit, and somehow they will have ulcers. Those spirits work together. Like, for example, if you have HIV, it will obviously invite TB, invite all those. There are spirits that if you allow one, it's going to call all others. Don't worry, in the positive, if you receive the Holy Ghost, all these things are
ezilungileyo ungamkela
umongweni
zonke izinto zonke
lezokulandela
uzakwa uzazamkela.
In the heart, that's where you have the spiritual eyes that you have
to be open.
That's where you have the inner ear. Did you know that your emotions affect the nervous systems? If you think negatively, your body will shrink. That's why you emphasize that we say I'm strong.
Confess
positive, never be negative. Do you know why children don't have BPs? Have you had a young child that was caught BP? BP, guys, how old?
BP, no,
never expect these young children to have BPs. A merry heart.
Buzz
like medicine. They found that children laugh more than 3,000 times a day in a start. And an adult. About 17 times a day. Someone is a first time now. So, because of their joyful heart. You know, a child, even if you beat them,
you'll
be holding the skirt of the mother. Though he sends me to hell, I will still love him. Even if he doesn't answer my prayer, I will still love him. Nothing shall separate me from the love of God.
Whether
pestilence or tribulation or
what,
gomera uripo, narini, you have to hold to God's unchanged. Now the prophet says, if you look through the looking glass, if you knew friend that is spiritual, you have to realize that every person has a spirit in them. If a person could only see what kind of a spirit dominates your life, I want you to go and do a homework. What kind of a spirit dominates your life? If you act too indifferent towards Christ, you'll be ashamed of yourself. No matter how you are dressed, how well, how you are popular, yet your heart, if you could look into your heart, into the inner man, now you may think this is wrong, but some of these days you will realize, if you could take a spiritual looking glass and look into your soul, you doubt and find what you are like. The greatest devil is the demon of unbelief. All the other things and gambling as the smaller demons. All those evil natures, they are hosting all those natures in them, sticky natures and weaknesses and appetites, stubborn spirits, the old nature. Now, true salvation removes the peacock spirit of pride. Removes the dog spirit of returning to your vomit.
Removes
the pig nature of going back to your mud.
And
the tortoise nature of going slow in the things of God.
And
the leopard nature of trying to lick your spots and be a hypocrite. And the snake nature of being slippery. When we
tried
to brother, we saw Jesus. No, it was my sister, it was my cousin. And the frog nature, jumping and not believing something in the Bible. The frog always looks back to the things of the world. Now a man, a human being, is like a rewrite
Buddhist.
We can remove all the things that the devil put in your life and
build
a new software and format all the things of the world. Now listen to this. It will unlock something very important. Now some people, they have something in their heart that they cannot forgive. They have scars of past life. Someone they cannot forgive. Spiritual wounds. They cannot trust anyone. Sometimes it's from early childhood experiences. Something happened to you when you were young. Now you can't get over that. And they are haunting thoughts that are always in you.
Now the prophet says,
umprofeti uthi yena,
those early spiritual childhood traumas
loko kuphatheka okubi umncane kwekwansi kukuphambanisa.
In discernment he says,
ekudaluleni uthi yena,
you are suffering with a nervous condition.
Kunomuntu unesimo sokuphatheka.
You had it since you were a little boy.
Wawune simo leso ungumfana.
Since you were a kid at school.
Ungumfana osasesikolo.
You get scared of something at time when you were young.
Oh, wawusesabenye into osasesincane.
It was a dog or something that crossed your path.
Kunyinja buya endleleni yakho.
Many years ago.
Emnyaka edluleyo kudala.
And that has made you a nervous person.
Sokwenza kubani ube nomuntu onokwesaba.
Prophet is saying, in another, it's many cases where he picks this.
He
says, how do you, it's in discernment. You speak English.
Says, yes.
You believe me to be God's servant.
Yes, I believe.
And that what the angel said to me.
And
said, if you get the people to believe you, not even cancer will stand.
He
says, yes.
He
says, if God can tell you what your trouble is, will you believe it?
He
says, yes.
He
says, you are nervous. It's a boy now. It's a scare that happened.
The
dog scared him, yes, that's right. He is going to get alright. There is a time when this young boy was scared by a dog. And from that time, he became nervous and is caught in
December.
There are some things that happen early in your life that affect you. Now you become timid and you are suspicious of people. But God can remove those things. If today was your last day, there's a time where your soul shall leave this body. One morning the doctor will probably leave the room saying nothing else can be done. The
lover
will be standing and folding their hands and crying, and the cold vapors of death floating over the bedside, the cold chilly winds of death sweeping, their pulse coming up their
sleeves,
breaking through the mist, and come the old ship of Zion to take him.
You have to be ready
at that time. Scientists have told something about this thing called near-death experiences.
When
Boswell was dying, though he was bedridden for some time, when he was about to die, the prophet asked him, he said, what is your best time, Boswell? He says, now.
What he gonna munch?
Some people will be screaming at that time.
Abanye abantu babe
kabala ngalolo soko. Some people will be trying to look for a preacher at
abanye
that time. Look for a preacher now.
Ting umfundisi
namhlanje. Look for your salvation now.
Ting usindisa namhlanje.
Then he jumped out of his bed.
Wasuka embedeni.
He started greeting some people.
Waqalisa ukubengelela abantu.
Oh, sister so and so.
Wasithathe sibani imali.
You made it.
Wanqoba.
I led you to Christ some days ago before you died.
Christu,
oh, brother so and so.
That is bani bani.
It was in that tent revival
there,
when you gave your life to Christ.
Lapho nikele impilo yakho ku Christ.
Greeting people and then he asked God,
wase
give me only 2 hours to pray.
Nginikeza amakholo amabili ukuthi ngikhuleke.
I fall by hands.
Ngingakagoqa izandla zami.
He did not die screaming and kicking
and afange khabalale
memes. When this earthly tabernacle is dissolved.
Waba kwazi kubana leli dokotela lomzimba lencibilika.
Bars of bones and
la maketana amathambo.
What they will best wide open and
hallelujah, glory.
When Stephen was dying, his face was like an angel. When Polycarp was dying, they saw like a dove flying out of him. Some people when they are dying
abanye abantu kuzophuma into emnyama
engcolileyo
umphefumulo ushiyayo
ebuyela everlasting destruction. So, you'll be between two worlds.
They say
there are two types of near-death experience.
Some,
they say when you are dying, your love flashes between you, before you.
All of it's
fast like lightning. And you cannot change anything in your past. Some people see themselves descending into light,
sinking
into darkness and torment. Those worlds are very true. I stood not long ago by the side of a man that was dying.
who
refused Christ and he was screaming and he was saying, take those demons away from me. They are wrapping me with chains. Look, when you are dying, something will come and take you. When you are dying, something will come and take you. He says, I stood by a woman's side who was dying. We had abortion cases, killing little children. She said, a little cold baby hands are running through my hair. Don't face those things, they are going to haunt you if you don't. When the prophet died, this is how the sky looked like, and like an eagle in the sky. They don't know what happened. It was the day when the prophet died.
Look,
a Russian scientist
tried
to photograph the soul when it's leaving the body. Listen, sinner friend, one day Jesus will call your name. One day that soul will leave your body. They took with the technique images of a soul. When life was leaving the body, the blue areas
where
life was still there. So you can see the blue fading in the next picture there. One day this body will remain dead. Where are you going? Some people be so disappointed because they came to church and they had no Holy Spirit. Your soul is on a journey. Where are you going? One of the days you shall pass from this realm. I'm afraid of that day. Listen, I've been buried long ago when I was baptized in Christ. So when you bury me, don't cry. Because I was buried in the waters long back. I cannot die anymore. When I'm buried in Christ, you can never die. That soul inside the ribcage and say, where are we going? Listen, ask yourself now, what is your eternal destination? We are spiritual astronauts. One of these days, I will fly away before I die. This old world will never hold us. There will be missing people, and we shall pass through the curtain of time and the toils of the road. We will see nothing. The big question is, in heaven, are we going to remember earthly things? Some of the good ones, some of the good memories, you shall remember them.
Hey,
that wicked man of Luke, rich man of Luke 16, remember when you were on earth. That was a painful memory. Some of you who shall go to hell, you shall be told, remember the four points. Remember the visiting ministers. Remember the altar calls. Remember the baptism announcements. Remember what can a man give? Seems now some soul to say,
God,
Spirit, go.
Now
I know there's been error that was taught. Especially SDA, they say a soul is when your spirit and body is equal to soul. Spirit plus body is soul. Yeah, that's error. That's why they say, when you are dead, you are resting in the body.
There.
Your soul is resting in the body. Your soul is dead there, is not moving. Even scientists through photography has seen. Listen, even doctors say you have three things that make you. The id, which is your flesh. The ego, which is your spirit. And the super ego, which is your soul. So everything is saying there are three things about you. Now in African traditional religion, they say, Gogo has come down, she's now doing like Gogo.
Gogo
soul will never come back. But that spirit that was acting in Gogo, if you invited it, can come and cough in you.
TP.
So that spirit will come and cough in you. But let me tell you, Christians, it's the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you. It will quicken your mortal body.
uzokuvuselela umzimba wakho.
What happened to the witch of Endor there?
Bahamba kanjani kule
Now, she called in divination.
Why senza? Why sanus?
And Saul came.
Gweza.
I know many people try to say no, it was an imitation of Saul, but the Bible says it was Saul.
Abantu bathi Saul.
You know, it was Saul, and he actually prophesied to. It was Samuel, so Samuel.
Gwagungu Samuel.
And he prophesied to Samuel, to Saul.
Was a prophet.
And he said, why did you disquieted me? Why did you waken me up? Now, when the blood of Christ was shed, that region, now we go to the sixth dimension. The devil cannot raise you up there. So, the true baptism of the Holy Ghost will change that soul. You will never be the same again. It is hidden life in Christ. It is the children of God in you. It is the overcoming power. It is the second baptism in you. He is the counselor. The spirit from the highest. The spirit of adoption. He is the spirit of counsel. Spirit of holiness. Spirit of life. Spirit of prophecy. Spirit of wisdom. The mind of Christ in you, the helper in prayer, the abiding guest, he is the former and latter rain,
it's
something that keeps bubbling in you,
he
makes all things possible,
he's
the old-time religion, he's the purifying fire,
he's
God's restoration agent, to restore everything that the devil
took,
he's the holy life of God, and our blessed assurance,
is
the sweet anointing.
He's
God and Morphe, the inward teacher. Is he that will convey the Pentecostal experience. The Pentecostal experience. He is the promise. If I got the baptism of the Holy Ghost, I'm going to heaven. That don't mean one thing that you are going to heaven. No. You can have the Holy Ghost baptism every hour in your life and still be lost and go to hell. The Bible says so. Why? Because you receive the Holy Ghost in your spirit and in your soul. Jesus said that the rain falls on the just and on the unjust. So you can have genuine Holy Ghost on a false person.
Now, a
demon is a tormentor. Many times you see a person, maybe of insanity, they may yet be a converted person filled with the Holy Ghost,
might
be insane. That doesn't have nothing to do with the soul. It's a torment that that person will be going to heaven. A man called me and said, a woman has got at least three devils. He said one of them is called Jess, the other one is called the other one didn't call the name of it.
Look,
intelligent people setting and supporting that. One of the demons is green, the other one is blue, the other one is pink. There's nothing like that, sniffing demons and things. Wrong demonology. Those unclean spirits like dragons and locusts and serpents and things, we are going to deal with them shortly. I'm about to close now. I wanted to compress everything so that you follow the TVT and go and start
it.
Those spirits, the prophet says, many times we see them Sometimes like a bird.
The epidemic
land like a tortoise with round. Sometimes some of them, they come in different and various forms. And some souls are in prison.
We
want to break those chains shortly as we are running to a close. All the powers of darkness, spiritual darkness, we are to break them today. All the powers of the devil. Listen, I want to run through the categories of these diseases of the soul. Powers of demons.
In Ephesians it
says these are principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. I want you to notice, if you find any of these in you,
we'll
deal with it shortly. Foul and unclean spirits in Matthew 12. Lying spirits in 1 Kings chapter 22. There are some people with the lying spirits. Even if there is no one who is going to beat them, they just lie. Different dumb spirit in Mark 9. Spirit of infirmity. Spirit of oppression. There are some people who are always having a heavy load. They are not
helping.
The prophet says, my personal contact with demons, they are just as real as you are. Many times they live right. I've seen them leave the platform here
in
shapes of birds and that one of worldly music was like a bird. But the epileptic one was like a tortoise. Listen to this one. Listen, usually the devil of oppression, those are always having stresses and what? It has a cloud form. Like a wave. The day you are worrying and having oppression, the demon that you have is like a cloud. There are some evil spirits of deception working miracles, Revelation 16, seducing spirits,
1
Timothy. Messenger of Satan just to buffet a Christian.
Spirits
of divination and horoscope and what? Don't look at those stars in horoscope.
We follow the horoscope.
Ancestral spirits, family spirits, spirits of the dead, generational things happening in your family. But when Christ died for us, man was refused in heaven. The highway was closed. There was no highways. But there was no highways. He came to make one. The first line was demon of doubt. The next one was prejudice. The next one was selfishness. The earth was covered with lines of demon powers and sickness. And so he broke all those powers so that you can be free today from the spirit of bondage in Romans chapter
8.
It makes people have temper and grudges. The spirit of heaviness written in Isaiah 61 makes you have depression and despair. The spirit of fear, you're always afraid that I'm going to die. The spirit of lust and immorality, pornography, prostitution,
dirty
habits, the spirit working in that department, a reprobate one, the gay spirit. I hate to see a boy throwing his fingers like a girl,
standing
like a man. You want to talk like you know, brother. You know, if you are a boy, it's not hormones, it's demons.
Lesbian
spirits.
And
you need the Holy Ghost to remove that. Those demons have tasks. The spirits of jealousy in Numbers 5. Selfish spirits and rebellious spirits in Revelation 2. Spirit of pride, it makes you despise all other people as you are the one. Spirit of insanity, Mark 5:3. Destructive spirit that make you always in accidents and suicide. There are some people who are always suicidal.
Spirit.
And tribal spirits. So, no, I will never marry a Shona. No, I will never marry a Ndebele. Here we marry a Christian.
So,
spirit. Look, there is another demon called Morpheus that make you sleep in church. But when you watch generations, you don't sleep.
There are
other occult spirit for Satanism and witchcraft. We are going to break all those. Immorality, demons, let's drop it. Let's those demons of immorality,
will
make you have spiritual husband. Those are diseases of the soul.
Empty
spirits, religious spirits.
But I would
like to hit this Laodicean one.
Hollywood
demons.
Modernism
demons. Internet and wealth.
Internet and TV.
Look, when demons are cast here,
says
many times demons have followed me in my room.
And
they've been rapping against me and girls and haunting me at night. Sometimes we cast demons here.
Yes,
if there is someone who doesn't believe, they just go into that person. Because they are opportunistic demons.
You
remember that one that attacked that woman who was at menopause?
It took advantage
of her situation. Some of the demons take advantage of her scar at childhood to affect you, make you shy. Some demons come when you are pregnant, and they will make you behave funny and say no. But it will be demons there. There are some demons that will take advantage of your laziness to read the Bible. Some of them take advantage of unconfessed sin. Some of them take advantage that you are dreaming. And they just come and take over and make you
feel.
Some of them take advantage that you have no husband, so they
come
a spiritual husband.
So
the prophet says sometimes demons scream for help when you cast the spirit of
God.
But I'm releasing it right now so that you pray powerful prayer. Demons,
yes, cutting it.
Someone they will be holding, they say no,
because
the demon I'm casting in this person may be the other, so they will be trying to. So, but we are breaking their chains. There are some things that the devil doesn't want you to know. Arthritis, someone with arthritis will be crying there also. Sometimes when I'm rebuking those, he doesn't want you to know these things, because you know you'll be invincible. The devil hates them all Jubilee songs. That's why it feels rock and roll in the church. He hates every beast of scripture, but more Genesis and Revelation. The devil hates the name of Jesus, but he's limited in your life. Though he roars like a lion, he's not a lion. Though he comes in one way, you will feel
similar.
I want to ask you, as I expose this
demon,
when does the devil have a claim in your life? There are times where we pray and pray and pray, and you don't seem to be freed. You may be having something of the devil in your life. You may be having dirty magazines in your home. So that demon has a right, as long as you have something that belongs to it. Many times we have been praying for people, then the demon says no, maybe behaving 100% human hair, and that person who gave you that hair, that demon is tormenting you. Many times we pray here and demons are pulling the hair. That's why I say a Christian, avoid worldly hairstyles. All those demons, so that they have no power in your life. So that, listen, the other thing, I will attack quick. There are demons that come through wealthy music. You find yourself failing to pray. It's the music that you are listening to. It's, you know, it bypasses the frontal lobe of the brain. In this picture here, the flowers started withering under rock and roll. But when they played good music, it started growing faster. Music therapists say the rock and roll bypass.
the pray, part of the brain that checks whether it's sense or what.
The prophet
says that man Elvis Presley.
With that
hooky hooky rock and roll,
it's
a strong spirit. I like church music to be played like church music, not rock and roll in the church. But when you get the spirit, say, they have something behind the devil putting those things. That hooky hooky, you become a tool in the hands of the devil. Those Pentecostal guys, they are Judas Iscariot of this time.
Elvis Presley,
you are a Pentecostal, sold this place right
now. Look,
if you are in church,
let's
have the hymnal songs. It cuts all those demons. And that red folly there.
Lou Red Folly.
He was the son of a deacon there.
When that name deacon?
Well, the music.
Many
of them are professing to be Christians. Some of them in an old rock and roll. They say they are Christians. If you are a Christian, listen to Christian music. I can prove without a shadow of doubt. When a woman is wearing a paint in their face, that is a hidden trait. And boogie woogie and rock and roll is an African dance of the heathen.
It's the devil polished up.
It's like a python coming. Now, as we are praying now, I want everyone to reject this day. If you didn't understand something, I try to compress it in one. So that you look for the DVD and run over it,
and
find about the diseases of the soul. So now let me talk to that wayward boy. That boy, that mama could not let go to church. Those boys that don't want to come to church. I'm not talking to you young boys. But by chance is listening now. That girl that is in teenage rock and roll. Teenagers. I want you to receive the Holy Ghost today. All teenagers. God let you know. That little body of his will be eaten by kangaroos soon. Then that wandering soul will be yonder in the regions of demons. If you are not born again, I'm asking you, when you leave this world, where are you going? I don't care how good a home a child has been brought up, or how he's been taught to do right. If that child isn't accepted the new birth experience, rock and roll music will catch his attention as soon as
they
are. And that's for some of the preachers that will let your church be like that. Any church that gets low enough to entertain young folks by rock and roll, change yourself outside there. It's not the house of God. Now, all those demons, as I call now those who want to repent, those who are tired of those things, we want to pray together. We are not laying hands on anyone
today.
Those who need prayer afterwards, they will remain. But I want you to refuse those spirits, to break the diseases of the soul. If there is something that affected you as I was preaching, and you saw that, no, these are the things that are disturbing me. Recently they put 15 harmful effects on TV on the children. The brother will put it in a PowerPoint and you will see 15 side effects of the television, those who are addicted to the TV. You will see that the demons that are jumping to the
people.
Those spirits,
lustful
demons jumping over you as you are watching wrong demons.
the wrong spirits
there.
They shown in a scan there that your
television
changes your brain way
medically
as it is shown
there.
Those who have been addicted to these things, let's come back home. Like Jacob put those trees there. When the cows were looking at that, they were changed. What they always
looked
at, they became what they were looking at. If you always look at wrong things, you become wrong in you. So now each one in their own way, let's come to a time of prayer. Persuade your heart where you are and say, now I need the Holy Ghost. Now I need perfect redemption. So I don't remember a day when I received the Holy Ghost. Listen, everyone who has never received the Holy Ghost, I invite you to receive the Holy Ghost today. I would like Brother Sipho to come and lead you in prayer so that you receive the Holy Ghost, so that you paralyze all those dark demons. If you are here and you have demon powers that will affect you and you are filthy in your behavior and you have the wrong music and wrong dresses and you are keeping grudges and you have wrong natures, today something can happen in your soul. Today Jesus is knocking in your heart. Those who have never had an experience with God, those who have never been born again, Jesus is here to change you. All teenagers were in rock and roll and wealthy music and reggae and R&B and T-Kong and wrong gospel music. It's time for you to clean up. And our musicians, it's time for us to go back to old time music. Holy Spirit, what the church needs today is a clean up in our spirit. It's a consecration.
Hallelujah.
If you are dying to yourself, if you want modernism in your life, you want a real genuine Holy Ghost in you. Is anyone needing the Holy Ghost today? Let the Holy Ghost come down right now. Let all demons go out right now. May the power of the Holy Ghost search through everyone. If you have something at the gable end of your soul, if you have aborted and you have not confessed, if you have done something wrong and confessed, if you have small houses and things, if you have secret sins, one day your soul is going to leave your body. What can a man give in exchange for his soul? Listen, sinner brother, even if you are a violent offender, the love of Jesus, the power of Jesus can change you right now. Listen, if you are here for the first time, I don't care what is happening in your life. Maybe your marriage is broken, is breaking. Maybe there's something that happened to you when you were young.
Hallelujah.
Maybe there are demons that are tormenting you. Maybe you are not sleeping at night. Maybe there are spirits of nightmares. Maybe they are haunting spirits. Maybe you are sorry for what happened to you. Maybe you gave poison to someone.
Amen.
Maybe you are not treating your husband right. Listen, that's going to break in the name of Jesus. Whatever happened in your life, even if you are married and divorced and married and divorced, now I address that demon over there in the name of Jesus. Leave here in the name of Jesus. Spirits are confused right now. If there is a time to receive your desire, I see the demons are confused. If there is a time to receive the Holy Ghost, God says, come down now. Confess your sins. If you have committed adultery, confess your sins. Maybe another brother, can you attend to the sister there? Can you attend to her there? Help her. Brother Chuba, Brother Zita and them. Can you help the sister there? By the power of the word of God. By the power of the word of God. We want to make sure our teenagers are free from evil spirits. We are here to defy the spirit of Laodicea. Anyone that is spiritual bondage, anyone that is high-tempered, anyone that cannot forgive, today Jesus can set you free. Listen, any demon of any sort, whether it's HIV or cancer, any sickness in your children, any spirit anywhere, we have power right now. Under this atmosphere, I want you to pray like never before. Parents are lifted and covered. Parents are lifted and covered. No demon can stand under this anointing. I'm addressing every one of those demons. What was making you poor, in Jesus' name, you shall be blessed. In the name of Jesus, whatever was stealing your money, whatever was stealing your joy, be delivered today. I call for a showdown right now. I call for a showdown. Whatever was stopping your job, come to Jesus today. Your job is coming. Your breakthrough is coming. You have been failing to receive the Holy Ghost. Promise God. Look for the deacons. Confess your sins. You want a revival here. All those family spirits, it has been following your family. Everyone in your family was being impregnated somewhere. Everyone in your family has never been successful. Those demons are falling right now. Church of God, respond to the anointing of God. Church of God, respond to the Holy Ghost. Respond to your visitation. The power of God is here in this room. Whatsoever you desire, I call you sinner man. Come to the altar right now. May the ministers help those who are at the altar who want to put a stamp. Those who have never received the Holy Ghost, Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Our Jesus, he is here to free you. He is here to save you. Whatever happened in your life, it doesn't matter anymore. All powers that were fighting your marriage, all powers that were fighting your children, all powers, all appetites of worldly music. Listen, friends, those who cannot break away from worldly fashions, those who cannot break away from worldly hairstyles, Jesus is calling you. Those who cannot break away from worldly music, Jesus is calling you. Those who cannot break away from internet pornography, Jesus is calling you. Those who cannot break away from these Laodicean spirits, I invite you today, come to Jesus. Oh, pray where you are. Don't get tired, pray. Don't be lazy, Christians. Don't pray like a jellyfish. Don't pray like you have never prayed. Don't pray like a salad someone. Pray like a Christian. Don't pray like you are fainting. Pray like a Christian. Shake the place where you are. Say, I must have something to happen today. Christians, where are you? Pray. Enter those dimensions. Christians, God is whispering to you. If there is something happening that you don't want in your family, we can break those spirits. If you have been trying and spirits are making you not married, the demons are saying you can never be married, you can come and we break those anti-marriage demons. Even if those demons are saying you can never have a wedding, listen, if those demons are saying you shall have miscarriages, come to Jesus. Those who have come and they are sick, come to Jesus today. Come to Jesus, you can be healed. Those who have HIV, come to Jesus. Those who cannot sleep, come to Jesus today. Those who are suffering and they don't know why they are living, those who are feeling like dying, come to Jesus today. My friends, it's later than you think. It's better than you think. Oh, friends, have you received the Holy Ghost? Have you received the Holy Ghost? If you are there, cry for the Holy Ghost. I tell you, it's not too easy to hear you cry. It's not too busy to attend to you. Ministers, can you come and help those who are praying? Can you come and help those who are in bed pains? It's the breaking of a new day. It's the breaking of a new day. All those spirits are under your feet. Your enemies are under your feet. In the name of Jesus. Your soul and your soul's diseases, as the soul leader comes. No friend like Jesus. There's no one who can heal all our soul's diseases. No friend like him. His soul we can hold. He can do anything. Nothing is impossible. Nothing is too hard. All things are possible. If you need a financial breakthrough, all things are possible. If you need school fees, all things are possible. If you need a house, all things are possible. If you need a car, all things are possible. If you need your loved ones to be saved, all things are possible. I challenge you, my brothers, don't waste this opportunity. Don't look at others. Pray where you are. Don't sleep. Pray where you are. Tell the devil, I've been wandering for long enough. Now I want to step into my realm. I want the Holy Ghost to work in me. Oh, sinners, confess your sins. Confess your sins. Oh, mothers, if you have cheated, confess your sins. My brothers and sisters, confess your sins. Go and see the deacons. Go and see your pastor. Don't be stashy. Don't be having pride. Go and confess. Start a new life. Be a new creature. God is here to change your life. God is here. Brother Sibo can lead us. I will step down here to help those who need prayer. Brothers, I know the Holy Ghost is real. Yes. I know you can receive the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
I know what I'm preaching about is real.
Hallelujah.
I know if you are hungry and thirsty.
Yes, Lord.
Young girls,
hallelujah,
have you received the Holy Ghost?
Hallelujah.
You're always coming here to church.
Hallelujah.
Have you confessed your sins?
Yes, Lord.
Oh, young boys,
help us, Lord.
If you die today,
hallelujah,
where is your soul going?
Oh, yes,
mothers and fathers,
yes, Lord,
maybe this is your last time.
Hallelujah.
What shall a man gain, my sister? Something can happen to you. I believe in an old-fashioned Holy Ghost meeting. What I met, I can help you to meet it today. As the Holy Ghost is moving, if there is condemnation in your heart, oh, sinner friend, is your life worthy of the gospel? If there is any condemnation in your heart, why don't you come to him today? Time is fast spent. The rapture is at hand. My desire is that everyone must receive the Holy Ghost. Don't get tired when you are praying. Your answer is right next to you. Your answer is right next to you. Pray, my sister. Break those veils of doubts. Break those veils of fear. Something is happening. Don't watch others. We are casting demons here. These spirits can leave another person and enter you. Mean business with your God. If you need another touch of the Holy Spirit, you can receive another touch. Maybe as the song leader sings, "Open trouble and Jehovah chase." No, not why. Open trouble, Jehovah chase. Jesus is among his people. Those who are through praying, they can go out. But we will work with those who desire in prayer. We'll help you until you get to your God. We'll help you until you receive your desire. So let us come forward. The Spirit of God is moving. I feel the Spirit of God. Don't go away with your problem. Don't go away with your natures. Jesus will meet you there. Jesus will meet you there. Burdens are lifted and covered. Don't leave this place without the Holy Ghost. Don't leave this place. I invite everyone who will use our time, even at midnight if you want. Those who need prayer, we are here to deal with every case. If you want to be here until night, those who need prayer, we are here to demonstrate the power of God. Others, let's sing prayerfully. Persuaded that soul of yours one day shall stand before its maker. Oh, that soul, my friend. Oh, teenagers, the world is pulling you. The Philistines are upon you. Break away from those spirits. Break away from those powers. Break away from those double spirits. Refuse your family spirit.